Seen strutting about in such.
Oh, let me wear this one, Mama. I love this one. It makes me feel like a little fairy queen.
But you're already in bloom. You make me forget all our good news. Just imagine, Vendla. Last night, the stork finally visited your sister, brought her another little baby girl.
I can't wait to see her, Mama.
Well, put on a proper dress and take a hat.
Mama? Don't be cross. Don't be. But I've been on for the second time now, and I still have no idea how it happens. Oh, Mama, please, I'm ashamed to even ask, but then who can I ask but you?
Vendla, child, you cannot imagine that I could.
You can't imagine that I still believe in the stork.
I honestly don't know what I've done to deserve this kind of talk, and on a day like today, Vendla, go, child, put your clothes on.
And if I were to run out now and ask Gregor our chimney sweep?
Very well, I'll tell you everything. But not today, tomorrow, or the day after.
Today, Mama.
Vendla Bergwell, I simply cannot.
Mama!
You will drive me mad.
Why? I kneel at your feet, lay my head in your lap. You can talk as if I weren't even here. Please?
Very well, I'll tell you.
Yes?
Child, I...
Mama?
All right, then. In order for a woman to conceive a child... You follow me?
Yes, Mama.
For a woman to bear a child, she must... In her own personal way, she must... Love her husband. Love him as she can love only him. Only him. She must love with her whole heart. There. Now you know everything.
Everything?
Everything, so help me.
Mama!
Mama who bore me. Some praise.
We superum sivae memoriam, unonis ob ira.
Bene, Helena Maya. Continue, Herr Zerchnitz.
Multa coque et bello passo.
Hey, Renault, from the beginning. Arma verunque cano. Troiae qui primus ab ori.
Hey, Robel. And?
Italium facto profugus dominique veni
victor. Estifol. Estifol.
Yeah, sir.
Continue. Please. Herr Stiefel.
Lavinia Que, Wainit.
Yes.
Litera? Multum.
Aini. Multum Aini?
Multum Oli.
Oli. Multum Oli. So then, somehow the pious Aeneas has already suffered much in the days still to come. Herr Stiefel, do you have any idea what you're saying, Herr Stiefel?
If you please.
Pardon me? If you please, Herr Sonnenstich, can't we at least consider multum olim as a plausible conjecture for how the text might read? Heck, boy, we are hardly here to conjecture about textual conjectures. The boy has made an error.
Yes, but an understandable error, sir. Indeed, if we could only entertain the fitness of the conjecture.
Multum olim?
Look to the fresh rhetorical balance. Multum olim introducing multa quoque. A parallel, sir, between what Aeneas has already suffered in war and those sufferings on land and sea just ahead.
Herr Gabor, since the days of Servius, Aulus Gellius, and Claudius Donatus, nay, since the moment of Virgil's death, our world has been littered with more than sufficient critical commentary on textual conjecture.
With all respect, sir, are you then suggesting that there is no further room for critical thought or interpretation? Why indeed then do we...
I am suggesting no such thing. I am confirming that Herr Stiefel has made an error. And I am asking, nay demanding, that you amend his faulty text and proceed from there. Do I make myself clear? Herr Gabor, do I make myself clear?
Yes, Herr Sonnenstich. Litera multum ile.
All of you, together with Melchior Gabor. Lavinia Cray Vinit.
Litera multum ile. Et feris iactatus et alto. Qui superum saevae primor.
Soon they bark and hound you till everything you say is just another bad about you. All they say is trust in what is written. Wars are made, and somehow that is wisdom. Thought is suspect, and money is their idol. And nothing is okay unless it's scripted in their Bible. But I know so much more to find just in looking through myself and not at them. Still I know to trust my own true mind and to say the way through us. On I go to wonder and to learning. Name the stars, know the dark returning. I'm calling to know the world's true yearning, the hunger that a child feels for everything they're shown. You watch me, just watch me, I'm caught in one. they all will know. You watch me, just watch me.
Thank you, gentlemen. Now, if you please, Inferetque Deus Latio, the following seven lines of Pius Aeneas' journey from memory.
Milky, thank you. It's nothing.
Still, I'm sorry. You didn't need to
think what Aeneas suffered.
But I should have known it.
Multum ille.
It's just, I didn't sleep all night. In fact, I suffered a visit from the most horrific dark phantasm.
You mean a dream?
A nightmare, really. Legs in sky blue stockings climbing over the lecture podium.
Oh, that kind of dream.
Have you ever suffered such mortifying visions?
Lords, of course. We all have. Otto Lammermeyer dreamt about his mother.
Really?
Georg Zirchnitz dreamt he was seduced by his piano teacher.
Fräulein Grossenbustenhalter!
Moritz Stiefel, I need hardly remind you that of all our pupils, you are in no position to be taking liberties. I will not warn you again.
Got a dream, there was an angel who could hear me through the wall as I cried out like in Latin. This is so not life at all. Help me out of this nightmare. And I heard her silver call. She said, just give it time, kid. I come to want it all. She said, give me that hand, please. And the itch you can't control. Let me teach you how to handle all the sadness in your soul. Oh, we'll work that silver magic. Then we'll aim it at the wall. She said, love may make you blind, kid. But I wouldn't mind at all. It's a miracle. And the music's like the one thing I can even get at all. And this breath on me, God, please just let those apples fall. It's the wish on the living. Nothing going on. Just a wish of the living. That's the one way to go.
Look so dusty on those khakis. Got my whole life.
gentlemen, turn in your verses and clear away your personal effects. I will see you tomorrow, 7 a.m.
Well, I'm off.
Me too.
I'll walk with you, Ernst.
You will?
We'll huddle over the Homer. Maybe do a little Achilles and Patroclus.
Melchior and Moritz?
Home to Bach?
Fräulein Grosse Boost and Halter will not be kept waiting.
Oh, Milky. 60 lines of Homer, all those quadratic equations. I'll be up all night, again, haunted by another of those dreams. And still, I won't get through it.
Oh, yes, your dream.
Milky, why? Why am I haunted by the legs of a woman? By the deepening conviction that some dark part of my destiny may lie there between them.
All right, then, I'll tell you. I got it out of books. But prepare yourself. It made an atheist out of me. So...
No, not here. No, I can't talk it. No. Do me a favor. Write it down. All of it. Conceal it in my satchel after gymnastics tomorrow. If you like, you could add some illustrations in the margins.
Top to bottom.
Everything.
Unfathomable. Fräulein Knüppeldick.
Herr Knochenbruch.
Look at that. Melchior Gabor, young man of distinct intellectual capability.
Thoroughly distinct.
A young man who could be our finest pupil.
Our finest, Herr Knochenbruch.
But there he is, polluting himself, cavorting about with that...
Neurasthenic imbecile Moritz Stiefel.
Thank heaven the upper grade only holds 60.
And the bodice all in lace, uh-huh, with the satin bowing back. Oh! And Fenla, what will you wear to Greta Brandenburg's wedding?
Mama said we cannot go.
To Greta's wedding?
Because she's marrying that forest inspector.
Mama felt it was a little improper.
But they're decking the entire sanctuary in orchids and chrysanthemums.
Mama said no.
I certainly hope your mama approves the man I marry.
And the man I marry. Well, we all know who Taya longs to marry.
Melchior Gabor.
And who doesn't?
He is rather handsome.
So wonderful. But not so wonderful as that sad, soulful, sleepyhead Moritz Stiefel.
Moritz Stiefel? How can you even compare them? Melky Gabor. He's such a radical. You know what the whisper is? He doesn't believe in anything. Not in God, not in heaven, not in a single thing in this world. They say he's the best in everything. Latin, Greek, trigonometry. The best part is, he doesn't care a whit about any of it. In the midst of this nothing, this mess of a life, still there's this one thing just to see you go by. It's almost like loving, sad as that is. May not be cool, but it's so where I live. It's like I'm your lover, or more like your ghost. I spend the day wondering what you do, where you go. I try and just kick it, but then what can I do? We've all got our junk, and my junk is you. See us winter walking after a storm. It's chill in the wind, but it's warm in your arms. We stop the snow line. May not be true. We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
Well done, Georg. And now, the prelude.
Have you prayed tonight? Yes. You don't look like you're praying, darling. Lying there, contemplating the coming bliss.
Anton, you all right?
It's my stomach again, Father, but I'll be fine.
Yeah? Fine. Well then. Darling. Don't think I take your murder lightly. The truth is, I can hardly bear to think of the long nights ahead. But it's sucking the marrow from my bones, seeing you lie there, motionless, staring at me so innocently. One of us must go. It's you or me.
No, no, King, please, again! And this time, bring out the left hand.
Darling, why do you press your knees together, even now, on the brink of eternity? Don't you see? It's your terrible chastity that's driving me to the mountain. That's enough in there.
Yes, sir.
Back to bed. Son.
1 minute?
1 last kiss. Those soft, white thighs. Those girlish breasts. Go, those cruel, cruel knees.
Repetez, s'il vous plaît.
Will you have to excuse me? I know it's so off. I love when you do stuff that's rude and so wrong. I go up to my room, turn the stereo on, shoot up some you in the U.S. song song.
My life I just drifted in a trail of these seas. Right on the rush, all the hopes, all the dreams. I may be neglected with the things I should do, but I've all got our junk.
October. The question is, shame. What is its origin? And why are we hounded by its miserable shadow? Does the mare feel shame as she couples with a stallion? Are they deaf to everything their loins are telling them until we grant them a marriage certificate? I think not. To my mind, shame is nothing but a product of education. Meanwhile, old Father Cowbox still blindly insists in every single sermon that it's deeply rooted in our sinful human nature, which is why I now refuse to go to church.
Melchior?
Yes, Mama?
Moritz Stiefel to see you.
Moritz?
Sorry, I'm so late. I yanked on a jacket and ran a brush through my hair and dashed like some phantom to get here.
You slept through the day?
I am exhausted, Melky. I was up until 3 a.m. reading that essay you gave me until I couldn't see straight.
Sit, let me roll you a smoke.
Look at me. I'm trembling. Last night, I prayed, like Christ in Gethsemane, please, God, give me consumption and take these sticky dreams away from me.
With any luck, he'll ignore that prayer.
Melky, I can't focus on anything. Even now, it seems like... Well, I see and hear and feel quite clearly, and yet everything seems so strange.
But those illustrations I gave you, didn't they help illuminate your dream?
They only multiplied everything 10 times! Now, instead of seeing stockings, I am plagued by labia majora. And
well, here we are with tea. Herr Stiefel, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you, Frau Gabor.
Yes?
Just think, Mama, Moritz was up reading all through the night.
Conjugating Greek.
You must take care of yourself, Moritz. Surely your health is more important than ancient Greek.
Now, what have you been reading, Melchior?
Goethe's Faust, actually.
Really? At your age?
It's so beautiful, Mama. So haunting.
Still, I should have thought. But surely you boys are now of an age to decide for yourselves what is good for you and what is not. If you need anything else, children, call me.
Well, your mother certainly is remarkable.
Until she catches her son reading Goethe.
I think she meant the story of Gretchen and her illegitimate child.
Yes. You see how obsessively everyone fixes on that story? It's as if the entire world were mesmerized by penis and vagina.
Well, I am. Yes, all the more so, I'm afraid, since reading your essay. What you wrote about the female, I can't stop thinking about it. This part right here, is it true?
Absolutely.
But how can you understand that, Melky? What the woman must feel?
Giving yourself over to someone else? Defending yourself? Until finally you surrender and feel heaven break over you? I just put myself in her place. And imagine. Really? What it feels like for the woman? Where I go, when I go there, no more memory anymore. Only drifting on some ship. A wind that whispers of the distance to shore. Where I go, when I go there, no more listening anymore. Only airs upon your lips, a mystic wisdom rising with them to shore.
Just like that, and that, oh yeah, now it's heaven. Not that I like, but that's so nice. Now look down where the pink flies.
Still, you must admit, with all the differing genitalia, it truly is daunting. What? I mean how everything might measure up. Fit?
More, it's not that I'm saying I myself have...
Oh, no, not that I'm saying that I wouldn't want whatever, want to not, whatever not want.
Moritz?
I have to go.
Moritz, wait! Moritz.
Melchior, what is it?
Nothing, Mama.
Has Moritz gone?
Yes.
Well, he does look awfully pale, don't you think? I wonder, is that Faust really the best thing for him?
Oh, 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 where I go, I go there, no more shadows anymore. Only you're there in the kiss, and nothing dancing as you're drifting.
The broken wishes washing with them to shore.
Touch me,
touch me.
All silent,
all silent.
Yes. Yes. All is forgiven. Touch, consume my wine, consume my mind.
Oh, I love you.
freedom, fallen from the branches. What are you doing alone up here?
Mama's making May wine. I thought I'd surprise her with some woodruff. And you?
This is my favorite spot. My private place for thinking.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, please. So, how have you been doing?
Well, this morning was wonderful. Our youth group brought baskets of food and clothing to the day laborers' children.
I remember when we used to do that, together.
You should have seen their faces, Melchior. How much we brightened their day.
Actually, it's something I've been thinking a lot about.
The day laborers?
Our little acts of charity. What do you think, Venla? Can our Sunday school deeds really make a difference?
They have to, of course. What other hope do those people have?
I don't know exactly. But I fear that industry is fast determining itself firmly against them.
Against us all, then.
Thank you, yes.
It seems to me that what serves each of us best is what serves all of us best.
Indeed. Venla Bergman, I've known you all these years and we've never truly talked.
We have so few opportunities now that we're older.
True. In a more progressive world, of course, we could all attend the same school, boys and girls together. Wouldn't that be remarkable?
What time is it?
Must be close to 4.
I thought it was later. I paused and lay so long in the moss by the stream and just let myself dream. I thought it must be later.
And can't you sit for a moment? When you lean back against this oak and stare up at the clouds, you start to think of not of things.
I have to be back before 5.
But when you lie here, such a strange, wonderful peace settles over you.
For a moment, maybe. Just too unreal, this. Watching the words fall from my lips.
Haven't you heard the word of your body? Don't feel a thing you wish.
Grasping at pearls with my fingertips.
You on the bridge in 10 minutes. Look, there he is! So, did you get caught?
No. No, thank God!
But you're trembling.
For joy. For pure and certain joy.
Cross your heart twice over.
Help you!
Moritz, I've been looking for you.
He snuck into the headmaster's office.
Moritz, what were you thinking?
I had to, Melky, I just had to. But the good news is, I passed.
The middle terms, that is.
Yes. Everything will now be determined by the final exams, but still. I know I passed. Oh, truly. Heaven must feel like this.
Well, well, Fräulein Knüppeldick, Herr Knochenbrock. Now that that skittish, neuraphasic moron
Moritz Stiefel
has somehow passed our middle term exams, it would appear we face a certain dilemma.
Ah.
The upper grade, as we know, will hold only 60. I hardly think we can promote 61.
Hardly, Herr Knochenbrock. But let us look to the finals ahead. Remember.
Yes?
If you come, who shall be marking them?
Then I am assured the good name of our school is secure.
Shall we take the short way home?
No, no, by the bridge.
After 2 hours marching with that medicine ball?
Someone wants to see. Has Melky Gabor taken a raft out?
Last one there has to hold hands with Hanushin.
Oh!
Oh. Oh, Marta, careful, your braid's coming loose.
Oh, no.
Just let it. Isn't it a nuisance for you day and night? You may not cut it short, you may not wear it down.
Tomorrow I'm bringing scissors.
For God's sake, Benlin, no. Papa beats me enough as it is.
Really?
No. No, it's nothing.
Marta.
Marta,
we're your friends.
Well, when I don't do as he likes.
What?
Some nights, Papa yanks at his belt.
But where is your mama?
We have rules in this house. Your father will not be disobeyed. The other night I ran for the door. Out the door? All right, I like that. That's where you'll spend the night, out on the street.
No!
I'm so cold.
My God. He beats you with a belt?
Anything.
With a buckle?
Right there.
Oh my God!
Marta, the welts, they're terrible.
We must do something.
Oh no.
But we must.
No, no, please. They throw me out for good.
Like what happened to Ilse, you mean, remember?
But still.
Anna, no. Just look what's become of Ilse now, living who knows where, with who knows who.
Just wish I could somehow go through it for you. My Uncle Klaus says if you don't discipline a child, you don't love it.
That must be.
Well, when I have children, I'll let them be free. And they'll grow strong and tall.
Free?
But how will we know what to do if our parents don't tell us?
Martha, time for bed now. There's a part I can't tell about the dark I know well. Marta, darling, put on that new nightgown, the pretty ruffled one your father bought you. You say, time for bed now, child. Mom just smiles that smile, just like she never saw me. Just like she never saw me. So I leave wanting just to hide, knowing deep inside you are coming to me. You are coming to me. You say all you want is just a kiss goodnight. Then you hold me and you whisper, child, the Lord won't mind. It's just you and me. Child, you're a beauty. God, it's good, the loving ain't it good tonight. You ain't seen nothing yet, gonna treat you child, you're a beauty.
Ilse, story time.
I don't scream, though I know it's wrong. I just play.
November. The trouble is, the terrible prerogative of the parentocracy in secondary education.
Herr Stiefel, may we have a word with you?
A world where teachers, like parents, view us as merely so much raw material for an obedient and productive society. A unified, military-like body where all that is weak must be hammered away. Where the progress of the students reflects back only on the rank and order of the faculty. And therefore, a single low mark can be seen as a threat to...
Melchior?
You.
I was lying by the stream and then I saw you here.
Yes.
So?
So, the stream. Dreaming again?
It was, I guess.
And what were you dreaming of?
Silly.
Tell me.
I dreamed I was a clumsy little girl who spilled my father's coffee. And when he saw what I'd done, he yanked out his belt and whipped me.
Then, well, that kind of thing doesn't happen anymore. Only in stories.
Marta Bessel is beaten almost every evening. The next day you can see the welts. It's terrible. Truly, it makes you boiling hot to hear her tell it. Lately, I can't think about anything else.
Someone should file a complaint.
You know, I've never been beaten. Not once. I can't even imagine it. It must be just awful.
I don't believe anyone is ever better for it.
I tried hitting myself. Find out how it feels. Really? Inside? With the switch, for example. It's tough and thin.
You draw blood.
I mean, if you beat me with it.
Beat you?
Me.
Emma, what are you thinking?
Nothing.
I could never beat you.
But if I let you?
Never.
But if I asked you to?
Have you lost your mind?
Marta Bessel, she
Fenla,
told
you
me...
can't envy someone being beaten.
But I've never been beaten. My entire life, I've never felt...
What?
...anything. Please, Melchior.
not. With your dress on.
On my legs, then.
Ben, look.
Come on! Please.
I'll teach you to say please.
You're barely still here.
How's that?
Marta's father uses his belt. He draws blood, Melky.
How's that?
Nothing!
And that!
Nothing!
You bitch! I'll beat the hell out of you! Father?
Moritz?
Yes?
Well, I was wondering, hypothetically speaking, what would happen if...
If
I were to... fail. Not that I'm...
You're telling me you failed.
No. I only meant...
You failed. Haven't you? I can see it on your face.
Father, no! Father!
Well... It's finally come to this. Damn right. So now, what are your mother and I supposed to do? You tell me, son. What? How can she show her face at the Missionary Society? What do I tell them at the bank? How do we go to church? What do we say? My son failed. Thank God my father never lived to see this day.
Dear Herr Stiefel, Moritz, I spent the entire day thinking about your note. Truly, it touched me, it did, that you'd think of me as a friend. Of course, I was saddened to hear that your exams came off rather less well than you'd hoped, and that you will not be promoted come fall. And yet I must say straight away that fleeing to America is hardly the solution. And even if it were, I cannot provide the money you request.
Well, fine, not like it's even worth the time, but still, you know, you wanted more. Sorry, it won't change, been there before.
You would do me wrong, Herr Stiefel, to read into my refusal any lack of affection. On the contrary, as Melchior's mother, I truly believe it to be my duty.
The thing that sucks okay for me, $1,000 of life scot-free, and I mean, please, it's all I need. Get real okay, but now you know the score.
Should you like, I am ready to write your parents. I will try to convince them that no one could have worked harder last semester, and also that too rigorous a condemnation of your current misfortune.
You want a life that's too absurd. You start to ask, can't hear the word. You wanna crash and burn right, tell me more.
Still, Herr Stiefel, one thing in your letter disturbed me. Your, what shall we call it? Veiled threat that should escape not be possible, you would take your own life?
Okay, so now we do the play. We act like we don't care, no way. You're right, my folks. Well, okay. Babe, that's how it goes.
My dear boy, the world is filled with men, businessmen, scientists, scholars even, who have done rather poorly in school and yet gone on to brilliant careers. Consider, for example, that rare and estimable...
They're not my own, not anymore. Not like they were before. Still out free and they're like, well, who knows? Who knows? Who knows?
In any case, I assure you that your present misfortune will have no effect on my feelings for you or on your relationship with Melchior.
Well, fine. Not like it's even worth the time. But still, you know, you wanted more. Okay, so nothing's changed.
Heard that before.
What a laugh is to the word. You start to ask and hear a word. You're gonna crash and burn.
And do let me hear from you soon. In the meantime, I am unchangingly and most fondly yours, Fanny Gabor.
Just suck it right enough, that's it. You'll still go on, well, for a bit. Another day of utter shits. Then there were none. And then there were none.
Out. Everyone's at church, rehearsing for our Michaelmas chorale. I slipped out.
Yes. Well.
Your friend Mort Stiefel is absent. Someone said he's been missing all day.
I expect he's had his fill of Michaelmas.
He you know I have your journal?
You do?
You left it the other day. I confess, I tried reading part
just
of it.
Leave it, please.
About what happened. Truly, I am. I understand that you'd be angry at me. I don't know what I was thinking.
Don't.
But how can I not?
Please, please don't. We were confused. We were both
but it
just.
It was my fault.
Don't,
that...
please, no. It was me. All me. Something in me. Started when I hit you.
Something in me too.
But I hurt you.
Yes, but still.
No more, my God, no more. Just, please. You should go.
Won't you come out to the middle now, Melchior? It's dark in here. Stuffy. We can run through the rain, get soaked to the skin, and not even care.
Forgive me.
It was me. All me.
I can hear your heartbeat right now. No matter where I am, I hear it beating.
And I hear yours. No, Kior. No, wait. No, I can't. We're not supposed to.
What? Not supposed to what? Love? I don't know, is there such a thing? I hear your heart. I feel you breathing everywhere. The rain, the hay.
No.
Why? Because it's good? Because it makes us feel something?
Yeah.
Let us turn today, children, to an adage much loved of Martin Luther. To God, to our parents, to our teachers, we can never render sufficient gratitude. How well we know. These words may strike our modern ear as merely quaint, as dubious, as old. And yet let us ask this question, each of us, within our dark heart. In what ways have we honored or dishonored our father and mother? In what ways have we strayed in soul, in body, from all the wise instructions of our clergymen, our teachers? Are you all right, Emma?
I think so. Something started crazy, sweet and unknown. Something you keep in a box on the street, it's for me, for a home. Make me untied, lonely and sad.
You can say what we are.
This is the season for dreaming.
Have we cloaked and hidden even from ourselves the secret bargains we have made with our own devils?
Now our bodies are the guilty
ones. Enough! Enough! Enough!
Like sadness.
don't need it in my life. I don't want any part of it. I just don't care.
More steeple?
It'll stop. You frightened me.
Did you lose something?
Why did you frighten me? Damn it.
What are you looking for?
Only I knew.
Then what's the use of looking?
So, where have you been keeping yourself?
Priapia. The artist colony?
Yes.
All those old buggers, Moritz. All so wild, so bohemian. All they want to do is dress me up and paint me. That Johann Ferndorf, he's a wicked one, actually. Always knocking easels down and chasing me, dabbing me with his paintbrush. But then that's meant if they can't stick it with one thing, they'll try another. Oh God, Moritz, the other day. We all got so drunk, I passed out in the snow. I just lay there all night, unconscious. Then the other day, I spent an entire week with Gustav Bell, truly hailing that ether of his. Until this morning, he woke me with a gun set against my breast. He said, one twitch, and it's the end. Really gave me the goosebumps. But how about you, Moritz? Still in school?
This semester I'm through.
God, remember how we all used to run back to my house and play pirates? Fenla Bergman, Melchior Gabor, you and I. Spring.
Actually, I better go.
Walk as far as my house with me.
And?
We'll dig up those old tomahawks and play together like we used to, Moritz.
Well, we did have some remarkable times. Hiding in our wigwam.
Yes. I'll brush your hair and I'll curl it. I'll set you on my little hobby horse.
I wish I could.
But then why don't you?
80 lines of Virgil, the 16 equations, a paper on the hot sports.
So maybe I should be some kind of on the line. I'll hang their things on me, and I will swing and dry. You just
But don't you sadly just don't care.
Good night, Nielsen.
Good night?
Virgil, the equations, do you remember?
Just for an hour.
I can't.
Walk me at least.
Honestly, I wish I could.
You know, by the time you finally wake up, I'll be lying on some trash heap.
Oh, for the love of God, all I had to do was say yes. Ilsa! Ilsa! So, what will I say? I'll tell them all, the angels, that I got drunk in the snow, and I sang and played pipes. Yes, I'll tell them. I'm ready now. I'll be an angel. Oh, 10 minutes ago, you could see the entire horizon. Now only the dust. First few stars. So dark. So dark. So dark.
Can't help the itch to touch, to kiss, to hold him once again. Now to close his eyes, never open them. The shadow passed, yearning, yearning for the fool, and call the talks you never had, the Saturdays you never spent, all the grown-up places you never went, and all of the crying you wouldn't understand. You just let him cry, make a man out of him. The shadow passed, yearning, yearning. They call out all things we ever wished are left behind. things his mama did to make him mine, and how his dad had hoped he'd grow. All things he ever lived are left behind. All the fears that ever flickered through his mind, all the sadness that he'd come to own. Oh. We must take immediate and decisive steps, lest we be perceived as one of those institutions afflicted by the veritable epidemic of adolescent suicide.
Indeed, sir. But it will not be an easy war to win. There's not only the moral corruption of our youth, but the creeping sensuality of these liberal-minded times.
I couldn't agree more. It's war. Naturally, there must be some casualties. Bring the boy in.
Certainly, Herr Knochenbrock.
It would seem, young man, that all roads end in you. You do know what I mean.
I'm afraid.
As well one would be. 2 days after his father learned of the young...
Moritz Stiefel.
Death, he searched through the boy's effects and uncovered a certain depraved and atheistic document which made terribly clear. The utter moral corruption of the young man. Corruption which no doubt hastened the boy's end. I am referring, as you may know, to a 10-page essay entitled, coyly enough, The Art of Sleeping With. Accompanied by, shall we say, lifelike illustration.
Herr Knochenbrock, if I could
behave properly, yes, that would be another affair entirely.
Entirely.
For our part, we have made a thorough examination of the handwriting of this obscene document and compared it with that of every single pupil.
Sir, if you could show
me. You must now answer only the precisely stated questions with a swift and decisive yes or no. Melchior Gabor, did you write this?
There's a moment you know. Woo! Not an inch more room to self-destruct. No more moves, oh yeah, the dead end zone. Man, you just can't call your soul your own.
really jump is that the weirdest shit is still to come. You can ask yourself, hey, what have I done? You're just a fly. The little guys, they kill for fun.
Man, you're fucked if you just freeze up. Can't do that thing that keeping still.
But you're fucked if you speak your mind.
And you know my heart, you will.
Yeah, you're fucked, sorry, I am a horse fight. You kiss your sorry ass goodbye. Totally fucked, will they mess you up? Well, you know they're gonna try.
Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Hey, come on. Disappear, yeah.
Woo!
You wanna try. Wanna bundle up.
Woo!
Long enough.
Woo!
Sometimes when it's quiet in the evening like this, I imagine myself as a country pastor. My red cheeked wife, my library, my degrees. Boys and girls who live nearby give me their hands when I go walking.
You can't be serious. Really, Ernst. You're such a sentimentalist. The pious, serene faces you see in the clergy, it's all an act to hide their envy. Trust me. There are only three ways a man can go. He can let the status quo defeat him, like Moritz. He can rock the boat, like Melchior and be expelled. Or he can bide his time and let the system work for him. Like me. Think of the future as a pail of whole milk. One man sweats and stirs, churning it into butter, like Otto, for example. Another man frets and spills his milk and cries all night, like Georg. But me, well, I'm like a pussycat. I just skim off the cream. Woo!
Just skim off the cream?
Right.
What about the laugh? What?
Cream away, please. Travel the world within my lips. Fondle the pearl of your distant dreams. Haven't you heard the word of your body? You're gonna be wounded. Oh, you're gonna be my wound. Oh, you're gonna bruise too. Oh, I'm gonna be your. I know. When we look back 30 years from now, tonight will seem unbelievably beautiful.
And in the meantime?
Why not?
On my way here this afternoon, I thought perhaps we'd only talk.
So, are you sorry?
Oh, no. I love you, Hanshin, as I have never loved anyone.
And so you should.
I'm gonna be wounded. Oh, I'm gonna be your wound. Oh, I'm gonna lose you. Oh, gonna be my bruise. Oh, you're gonna be wounded. Oh, you're gonna be my bruise. Oh,
I have now seen, Venla, how this contemptible bourgeois society works. How everything we touch is turned to dirt. In the end, we have only each other. We must build a different world. Despite what those whispering elders may say, I must set my head against your breast. We must let ourselves breathe and move again in that paradise.
Now, don't fret. I've been prescribing these since before you were born, young lady. In fact, I recently recommended them to the utterly exhausted young Baroness von Witzelbein 8 days later. I am pleased to report. She's off to a spa in Piemont. breakfasting on roast chicken and new potato. So, my child, three a day, an hour before meal. In a few weeks, you should be fine, breakfasting on suckling pig, no doubt.
So that's all it is, doctor. Anemia.
Sattu?
And the nausea?
Not uncommon. Trust me, child, you'll be fine. Frau Bergman, if I could have a word with you.
Certainly, doctor.
What have you done to yourself, to me, Velma?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Dr. von Brosepulver said I'm anemic.
Well, probably. You're going to have a child.
Child? But I am not married.
Precisely. Velma, what have you done?
I don't know. Truly, I don't.
Oh, I think you know. And now I need his name.
His name? But what are you... Ben? But how could that happen? I just wanted to be close to
Ben, to hold him. No more! You'll break my heart!
My God! Why? Why didn't you tell me everything?
Well, you're going to have to tell me who. Wendla, I'm waiting. Georg Zirchnitz? Then who? Hansen Rilo? Moritz Stiefel? Melchior Gabor? Wendla Melchior Gabor? Wendla!
For 15 years, my darling, I have followed your lead. We have given the boy room, and now we must eat of the bitter fruit. He has shown himself utterly corrupt.
He has not.
Hear me out.
But I have. Melchior wrote an essay, every word of which was true. Are we so afraid of the truth? We will join the ranks of cowards and fools, twisting his naive act into evidence against him? I will not have Melchior sent to some reformatory, pent up with degenerates and genuine criminals.
See the fire burn to breathe, mother dressed in mourning, sister crumbles, and the neighbors grumble.
Now I must break your heart. This afternoon, Frau Bergman came to see me, bearing a letter Melchior wrote to young Wendla, telling her he has no regret for what transpired in our hayloft.
Impossible.
That he only longs to find again that bit of paradise.
Let me see that.
Yes, do help.
Little miss, didn't you write? And ruined all the true plans.
wretched factors. Melchior knew precisely what he was doing. And as that essay shows, he knew the danger of doing it. And yet he went ahead, defiling himself and all but destroying that girl. So you tell me, Fanny, what shall we do?
What you will. A reformatory.
Had a sweetheart on his knees, so faithful and adoring, and he touched me, and I let him love me, so let that be my story.
I only pray this letter reaches you. I have written so many and have heard nothing back. When I think of your life in that terrible place, my heart aches. If only I could be close to you and talk to you. I have such remarkable news. Something has happened, Melchior. Something I can barely understand myself.
All right, each of you animals, put in a coin.
Reinhold can put in for both of us.
I beg your pardon?
All right, you calm down. Reinhold, cough it up.
Christ.
Rupert Mobrecht, you too. Now, whoever hits him, gets him.
Wait, what are you looking at?
Who?
You're bored.
He just wants part of the sport.
No, thank you.
Oh, no. Why would he dirty his hands?
You're saving it for better things.
What do you mean?
Oh, a good girl, wasn't she?
Yeah, nobody taught the poor boy what parlor maids are for.
He was too busy fucking his slut.
You shit!
Careful. Razor burn.
Bastard! Check your pockets for money.
What's this? A letter from his bitch?
My dear Melchior, I only pray that this letter reaches you. I have written so many and have heard nothing back. Ooh, hang on. The perfect thing to grease the works. Listen up.
Son of a bitch!
Frau Bergman.
Thank you for meeting me. Your name was given me by a doctor friend. My daughter...
I understand. Now, listen to my instructions carefully. This Thursday, after nightfall, bring the girl to me. Gartenstrasse number 11, the door below the tavern, knock three times, and only three.
But my daughter, the procedure, is it safe?
We do what we can.
In my bed each night, I have so many dreams of the better world that we will build together with our child.
Child?
You didn't know. Put a pup in the bitch and didn't even know.
Forget the coins, we'll use mommy's letter.
And you can lick it up.
Goodbye! Get on!
Mama?
Good, I'll take it.
Mama?
I'll be there with you every moment.
Mama, don't leave me! Mama! Mama!
Ilsa, I have been running for days, but at last I am back. Now I beg you, for the sake of our old friendship, bring Venla to meet me tonight in the graveyard behind the church.
Oh no.
I will be waiting there at midnight. Melchior Gabor.
So he hasn't heard.
Waiting for Venla.
Poor Melchior. Poor Venla.
Hmm.
this? Spend your life running from the church, and where do you wind up?
Moritz. My old friend. Well, they won't get to me. Or Venla. I won't let them. We'll build that world together for our child.
Tombs.
And here, a fresh one.
Here rests in God, Venla Bear.
Born to die. Oh my God. Venla too? No! No! No!
Those you know lost to walk behind you, all alone, linger till they find you after the fall. Without them, the world grows dark around you. Nothing is the same until you know that they have found you.
Well, you had the right idea. They scatter a little earth and thank your God.
Those you've claimed in paradise to be found, all the same, the whisper of forgiveness. Still your heart says the shadows bring the starlight, and everything you've ever been is still there in the dark night.
You know you've left Venla behind. You won't run by yourself, not with us. You know deep in your heart and mind when they say another wind that no one yet has known. They call me so through all things, nights falling, somehow on I go. You watch me, just watch me. Through the winter light, I will read all their dreams.
leaves to the stars. I'll walk now with them. I'll call their names. I'll see their thoughts are known. Not gone. They walk with my heart. Just watch me, I'm coming. I'm coming, and one day all will know.
Yeah. much to every single one of you for being here tonight. We love you so much, and thank you. This night sold out in 3 hours, so thank you for that. And it sold out in 3 hours in love for the Actors Fund. So now I'm going to read a little about why we're all here tonight in this room, other than to celebrate our incredible show.